She threw me, she threw me, she threw me, she threw me, she threw me. She threw me, she threw me, she threw me, she threw me, she threw me.
I think what you're trying to ask is, why am I so insistent upon giving out to them that blackness, that black power, that black pushing them to identify with black culture? I think that's what you're asking. It's I have no choice over it. In the first place, to me, we are the most beautiful creatures in the whole world, black people. I mean, and I mean that in every sense, outside and inside. And to me, we have a culture that is surpassed by no other civilization, but we don't know anything about it. So again, I think I've said this before in the same interview, I think at some time before, my job is to somehow make them curious enough or persuade them by hook or crook to get more aware of themselves and where they came from and what they are into and what is already there, and just to bring it out. This is what compels me to compel them. And I will do it by whatever means necessary.
Peace and blessings, my fellow queens. It's that time again. Black Women's History Month, March 31st, 1 p.m. to 5 p.m. This year, we are pleased to announce that the Southside Community Arts Center, under the leadership of Mama Masekwa Myers, will be our host venue. What is She Through Me? She Through Me is an invocation of sorts in which we seek to heal and learn and grow through the embodiment of an ancestor. How powerful on an individual level to connect with an ancestor, be it in your own bloodline, be it someone you've never met personally, be it through music, be it through film, theater, literature, and really study them. How did they think? How did they feel? What was the sign of the times when they were living? What was their soapbox? If they were a musician, how did their music embody the time? How did their literature embody the era in which they lived? You know, from a collective vantage point, when we all come together and share a piece of ourselves through the life and time of the ancestor, what growth takes place. There's so much to be learned. There's so much to share. This is how we commemorate. This is how we keep their spirit alive. And last year, they were really happy. Really, 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 really happy. So let's dive right in. I always like to speak squarely and candidly to my sister so that we can have an amazing ritual reunion that is in keeping with tradition, in keeping with the honoring of our ancestors, but also enjoyable and a really good time.
Costumes.
So, there can only be one of each ancestor. There can be no duplicates. The spirits have emphatically made this clear to me. So, what I will do is I will keep a running list on the event page. Please check it often if you have not already chosen an ancestor. I already have a short list because I did give priority to the people, to the sisters who participated last year. As soon as I have your ancestor, the first thing I will do is add it to the list. Now, please, I can't say this enough. Before you submit your ancestor, be sure to check the list. Next, vittles, because y'all know we love to eat. As we research our ancestor, I want you to think of what would that person bring food-wise or beverage-wise to a soiree of sisters, a town hall meeting of sorts, a sister circle, a ritual reunion. Last year we had a feast, a divine feast. Put your heart into it. We're feeding one another. To feed is spiritual. So really put your heart into feeding one another, because we want to eat good. At the actual event, you must stay the entire time. From the moment you walk into the gallery to the moment you exit the gallery, you must remain in character. This is not just a costume party. This is a spiritual, a deeply spiritual celebration of those who paved the way for us. Those who were so that we could be. Those whose legacies and energies and spirits still live on. They're everywhere. Start now figuring out what would they wear. You can visit local thrift shops. If you have any questions about places you could possibly look, just inbox me, no problem. Chicago is also chock full of really cool costume shops. Ask your aunties, your cousins, your neighbors, all kinds of cool stuff lurking right there in the closets of your own relatives. So let's get started right now. Start looking, deciding how could you best embody this ancestor. What would they want to wear? The message. Around 3 o'clock, we will begin our ritual reunion sister incantation circle. Each of us will do a 3 to 5 minute presentation. It could be a song, it could be a poem, it could be a speech, it could be a word, it could be a scripture, it could be a thought, it could be whatever you feel that your ancestor would share with a group of women who have come together to figure out how to make a positive change in the world. What would your ancestor bring to the table? What would they say? Would they dance? Would they sing a song? Would they recite a poem? What would they bring to the table? This year's theme is, where do we go from here? There will be a photo shoot where we will capture each woman as her ancestor of choice. Amazing. So we just want to give thanks. We just want to let them know in the best way that we can that we see them and we appreciate them. She through me.